so much for joining us here in Ann Arbor from wherever you are watching. We are the Carpe Diem String Quartet, Charles Wedley, Marisha Ishikawa, Ariana Nelson, and I'm Corrine Fujiwara. And we are thrilled to be playing music in the same room, under the same roof, and so glad that you are joining us. We would like to thank the great roof of the Stone Chalet and the people who run it for making this possible, and also a tremendous amount of thanks to the Great Lakes Performing Arts Associates and the board of directors of Great Lakes Performing Arts Associates for making this possible, for able to bring our music to you wherever you are in the world. We've got a very diverse program for you today, all sorts of different composers from different parts of the world, and we look forward to sharing that with you. So wherever you are, get yourself comfortable, turn up the volume, and welcome to our concert.
We're going to begin with the quartet in C major by Mozart. And like many quartets by Haydn, Joseph Haydn, and Mozart, this quartet has a nickname. It's called the Dissonant Quartet. Now, as you listen to it, you may start to wonder a little bit, if you remember that title, why is it called the Dissonant? Because, in fact, like most of Mozart, it's a beautiful melodic work, and quite, to our ears, I think, conventional in its harmonies. But it opens with a slow adagio, and for its time, this opening was considered radical. It doesn't establish the key of C major. It starts on a C, starts to suggest C minor, but then goes somewhere else. And throughout the entire introduction, you are wondering what key you are in. And as I said, at the time, this is something that composers just didn't do. So this chromatic and ambiguous opening led to the title, Dissonance, even though once we reach the main part of the first movement, the Allegro, and from then on, it is anything but. It's a gorgeous quartet in four movements, follows again a rather conventional, if you will, format of the first movement, which is after the slow introduction, fast, a slow movement, and then a minuet and scherzo, a trio that suggests perhaps a little bit of the kinds of drama that Beethoven was soon to inject into his works, substituting a scherzo for a minuet and trio. And then finally, the last movement, which I just love playing, it just bubbles over with enthusiasm and fun. The inner voices get all kinds of little rockets that they produce, and we're pinned down by our cellist Ari. So enjoy the Mozart Dissonance.
Thank you. Thank you.
for being here, and thank you for watching wherever you're watching from. If you have been watching on Facebook, that will disappear, so please join us over at the Crowdcast link, which should be in the description of the Facebook event, so you can register for the Crowdcast stream. So the next piece we're going to play is called Middle Ground, and it was written by Shelley Washington in 2015. Shelley Washington is a composer in New York City, and she is part of this very cool composer collective called Kinds of Kings. So she wrote this piece dedicated to her family, and she wrote a beautiful piece of poetry, which I'm going to read a couple excerpts from. Middle ground, the space grounded, the between, the center, the heartland, the prairie, the grasslands, Konza, Flint Hills, Manhattan, Emporia, Salina, where we gathered. The middle ground, my refuge born from the land living in my heart, where my home is, living and breathing outside of my body, thousands of miles apart, this hallowed ground.
Thank you.
The next piece we are going to play for you is Claude Debussy's Quartet in G minor. Debussy wrote this piece when he was only 31, and he had intentions of writing two quartets, but unfortunately only wrote one, but fortunately he did write one. So we are very grateful for that. Debussy was writing music around the same time as French Impressionist painters were painting. So a lot of times I like to think about the sounds and colors that we produce out of our instruments, similar to the palettes and the images that those painters might have used at their time. So with all four of these movements, I hope in your own imaginations you see four very different paintings and really enjoy the sounds and colors that we produce.
Thank you. Thank you.
conclusion of our printed program, which we don't have. So that leaves us free to improvise. And we thought we might just add one more work for you.
This work is a piece that I composed for Carpe Diem String Quartet. It's become a bit of a signature piece for us. It's called Fiddle Suite Montana. And we always find, especially the fourth movement right now, called Cherry Blossom, especially timely. It celebrates life and how very transient it is, how extremely easy it is to forget that, as we all know. And so it reminds us to live for right now and appreciate who you have and what you have right now, because it can change in a minute. The final movement is a celebration of life in a good old-fashioned party kind of music way. It's called Pease Bottom, which is an actual location in Montana, out near Hysham, if you've got your maps out, and Custer, sort of in the southeast part of the state. I grew up in Montana. It's my tribute to my heritage and my gift to you, to thank you all from where you are, if you are here in the hall or if you're watching online. Thank you for joining us today, and stay well and enjoy the music.
Thank you.
wonderful to play for you this afternoon. Thanks everyone for being here. Thanks for everyone who joined us online. It's really wonderful to share music with you. Have a great rest of your day.
Thank you to the Stone Chalet. Thank you, Great Lakes PAA. Thank you to the Board of Directors of PAA.